Bhagavad Gita. As you all know, Bhagavad Gita is the essence of conversation between speaker and seeker, that is Lord Shri Krishna and Arjuna, where Shri Krishna clears n number of doubts of Arjuna. We are living in such an environment which is full of competition, comparison, and we find n number of negativity around us. So in such a situation, the first thing which strikes in our mind, how we can keep our child safe and secure, untouched from such kind of negativity. So it is very surprising to know that the verses of Bhagavad Gita, there are so many verses of Bhagavad Gita which we can use in our parenting for making our child emotionally, mentally strong along with physically. So now today, this is the high time. This is the time where we should learn it, we should implement it, we should practice it. Why we should wait till 60 years or 70 years for reading such kind of holy book? Why not today? Because this is the correct time. And how we can use these verses in parenting, these things I am going to show you in this video. So before starting my video, I request you all, those who are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe my channel and press the bell button icon which is highlighting on the left side of the screen. And if you like it, then please like, share. So without wasting time, let's start. Gives messages which include enlightenment and encouragement. Enlightenment, which what we should do and why we should do. Encouragement, we can do. Whatever we are saying to our child regarding do's and don'ts, we should explain with examples. We should always try to make them understand whatever they will do in their life, they have to be ready to face the consequences, whether it is good or bad. Gita, Shri Krishna explains regarding different yoga. It means Shri Krishna put different yoga in front of devotees. Means he is giving multiple options in front of devotees, and the last call will be of devotees. So in the same manner, we should give multiple options to our child. We should not impose any particular act or particular expectations on our child. And at the same time, we should be confident about the lessons, education, enlightenment we have given to our child. This truth. We should always encourage our child to say the truth without any fear. In this way, we would be able to create a strong bond with our child. And go. Suppose your child is asking for any toys which he finds very much interesting only because his or her friend is having, then in that situation we should try to make them understand this particular toy which is very much interesting and important today might be after 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, or after a week. It must not be that much important. So we should teach the lesson to control their senses, to control their desires. About the result. We should not think about the result all the time. We should encourage our child to do their work honestly. We always discuss about the result, parinam, phal. But we should discuss about the action. I have already explained about the consequences. Whatever we are doing, we will face the consequences also. Consequences, the same, you know, it's result only. Not any one day short. It is a practice that we need to do throughout our life. So start from today. Hare Krishna. Somehow, if you find this video useful and valuable, then please like, share and subscribe. I'll come again with more and more useful and interesting videos. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.